Hey, what's up, car shipping rock stars? It's your girl Ashley from RelogeeK.com. And on this podcast, we are talking about making money in an oversaturated auto transport industry, or as like some people like to call it, watered down. Now, I'm going to make this short and sweet. Can you make money in this oversaturated industry? Heck yeah. If it was me and I was trying to start my business in this oversaturated industry today, would I still start? Heck yeah. And here's why. Here's the keys to succeeding in this oversaturated industry. And I talked about this in the video series a long time ago when I first started coaching you guys, but you have to educate your clients. Always, always, always educate. You have to be yourself. That's a given. And you have to set expectations. Those are the three keys to making it. Now, I'm not going to go into detail clearly because I've already done that in that video series. So if you go on YouTube and you look into the brokering videos, you will find it somewhere deep down in there. It's called three keys to success in your auto transport business. But I wanted to add another key factor here. I got asked this last night about is it smart to jump into this oversaturated, watered down industry? And the thing is, if you're dependent on leads and your main goal coming in is I'm going to just buy leads and you're not setting yourself up for a sustainable business model by actually, you know, bringing in your own clients and you're only dependent on leads, then I feel personally like you're setting yourself up for failure. If you talk to any successful auto transport business owner, or anybody that's been in this business for a long time, they will tell you that getting your own leads, like basically generating your own leads, it's easier to convert and the clients will always be better to deal with. And let me just give you a quick story that's going to drive home this point. When I was an auto transport broker, I believed strongly in being my authentic self. And I put myself out there. I have a unique personality. I'm quirky. I'm very corny at times. You know, I have humor. I cuss when I feel like it or if I need to. I don't say derogatory cuss words, but I'll say a damn here and there or hell yeah. And I also had like this intellectual level and a high level of experience that I wanted to combine and target a very difficult market, which was the corporate relocation market. So I branded myself that way. I put myself out there that way. Now, when I was buying leads and trying to do that, what I noticed was that when I was buying leads, that it was a lot harder and it took a lot longer for me to convert these clients. I literally would spend 45 minutes to an hour on the phone with each client. And I know some of you salespeople out there are like, that's impossible. How did you make any money? Well, when you're charging $300 to $400 at times, sometimes $500 per move. Yes, I was charging a lot of money per move and it accounted for that time differential. And especially when I spent time converting these leads, they were more than likely 97, 98% of the time converting. So I didn't have to say, you know, I didn't have to try to talk all this time and then that client go on to pick somebody else. That usually never, ever really happened because I spent the time, quality over quantity. However, so the point is when I started blogging and I started bringing in my own clients, I noticed a big difference. Those clients were coming to me. Those clients were already sold on me. Those clients wanted to do business with me. I didn't have to convince them. Those calls only lasted 5-10 minutes. It was just, hey, Ashley, how much is it going to cost to do this move? This is how much it's going to cost. Okay, get it done. And it was as simple as that. Now, obviously, I overly simplified that, but it literally went like that. And if they had a couple questions, I answered them. And still, they give me their card number. I booked the move, had 0 chargebacks. I had no chargebacks the entire time I was a broker. When I was a call hauler, a broker, I've yet to have had any chargebacks. So basically, my point of this is that there was a big difference there. That was an eye-opening moment. That's when I determined that I'm not buying leads anymore. I'm going to spend my time generating leads. I'm going to do everything I can. And as I said, if you ask any broker that's been in it any amount of time, they would tell you that referrals, aka word of mouth, people who've done business with you or talked about you, is easier and better to convert than buying leads. Getting your own leads is easier and better to convert. I use different methods to generating my leads. Most of you guys know about blogging because that's what I talk about. Some of you guys have been contacting me about my lead generation ideas in my shop. And those lead generation ideas are things that I actually used in my business. So I know they work. They work wonders. So the point of this is that, yes, you can make money in this oversaturated, watered down industry. And yes, it's going to take a lot more creativity, thinking outside the box, doing things, following those lead generation tips that I give you when you purchase that auto transport lead generation cheat sheet. So those are things that are going to help you make it. However, you know, if you're, again, if I, like, if your personality, and this is why I say, even though being your authentic self is key to separating yourself from every other broker, so you're different, you're always going to be different because there's only one you. Also, you also got to do the things that's going to help you. It doesn't make any sense to have this awesome website that reflects who you are and what you do, but then you're buying leads from. And to be fair, with lead providers, they're just throwing, they're marketers. So they're just throwing up these websites that probably say things like ship your car from wherever to wherever for $500 or moves for $300 or the best competitive pricing. So when you now as the broker are giving them a price and these clients are like, well, you know, I thought it was going to be like $500 or I thought it was going to be $600. And you're wondering why you're being met with resistance. That's why there's a difference there. So their website is saying one thing and these clients don't understand that the reason for the difference is that they filled out one of those forms and now you are paying for their information. And that was something that I used to tell clients. I had no problem telling them, I got your information because you did XYZ. That's one of the reasons why I can see why you'd be nervous is if your goal is to buy leads, then you're, like I said, you're setting yourself up for a lot harder time standing out. Now, there's a big difference. People say, well, what about exclusive leads? Like if I'm buying leads that are shared with 2 to 3 other brokers, is that, you know, is that bad? And I say it's better than buying shared leads. However, it's still the difference because these people are still going through somebody else before they get to you. Like they're like, you're a middleman, right? You're already a middleman because you're the middleman between the client and the carrier. Now you have another middleman, the middleman between you and the client. You see what I'm saying? So they're going through a bunch of different channels before they reach you and it just clouds everything. And I'm not saying this to say lead providers are not worth it or, you know, they're bad people. Obviously there are some bad lead providers out there that do less than honorable things, but for the most part, what I'm trying to say, the point I'm driving home is leads have their place. You know, I did a whole video about this before already, that leads have their place. So as long as you're coming into this industry thinking or knowing and have a sustainable business plan that says, you know, this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to buy leads right now, but during that time that I'm buying these leads, I'm building up my business. I'm building my brand. I'm being authentically me, and I am going to genuinely, sincerely care about my clients, and, you know, you're going to win. So I hope this podcast really help shed some light and give you some type of inspiration or some clarity into whether or not you should jump into this oversaturated, watered down industry. As I said, me personally, if I was starting my business today and I know what I know now, I definitely would still jump into the business. I would. And that's just my personality. Maybe it's not for you. Maybe this is enough to make you run away. And that's cool too. So that's it for this podcast. That's all I have for you guys today. Thank you for listening. If you think this podcast was helpful, be sure to share the link with whoever you know that could be inspired by it. I'm Ashley from ReloGeek.com. Now get out there and make moves happen. I will talk to you guys soon.